In this video, I will walk you through the process of solving the Rubik's Cube Mini. You can tell it's mini here because notice since the standard Rubik's Cube has three cubes across the top and the mini has two. And you can see here, we call it a 3x3 or a 2x2. So we are going to focus on the Rubik's Cube Mini in this tutorial. Here you've got the solution guide and here's your cube. I'll rotate this just to make it a little easier to see. So right now at the top layer is this blue set of cubes and the bottom layer is the orange set of cubes. And notice they rotate independently. The cube is also made up of faces. So the face is the flat part. Think about your hand as the face. So I have the up face and the down face, which right now are white and yellow. Then I have a left face, which is red, the orange right face, front face is blue, and right now it's green for the back face. I came up with a little chant for my students to help them remember the different faces. Left, front, right. Left, front, right. Up, down, up, down. Don't forget the back. Don't forget the back. Left, front, right. Left, front, right. Up, down, up, down. Don't forget the back. Don't forget the back. So as you're using your cube, make sure you're paying attention to the faces in which direction they are pointing. If you start rotating your cube and all of a sudden my top face is now my front face, the algorithm in your solution guide will not work. So that's very important to make sure you orient yourself to the faces. You can see here in the guide, the motions. This motion, the top and the bottom face is like opening a bottle. The right and the left face turns are like a Ferris wheel. And then the front face and the back face turns are like a doorknob. Down here, you're gonna notice the algorithms, actually they're over here as well. So you see U for the up face and U inverse. Where that comes from, and you can see down here, is the notion of clockwise and counterclockwise. So I want you to see what that looks like. So I have these little pictures right here. So imagine a clock face, and I know a lot of you may not have these clocks in your houses anymore, but the way that the hands move around the clock is called clockwise. So when I'm rotating this face, that is the clockwise direction, even if it's my right face. Notice how the clock is going around in the same direction. Or if it's my bottom face, that's still the clockwise direction. I can also do counterclockwise. And that's what whenever you see in the algorithm, this little mark next to it, it stands for the inverse. And if you are looking at that particular face, it's the counterclockwise direction like this. Doesn't matter which direction the face is. This right now, it's the top face, that's still counterclockwise. If that's my left face, that's counterclockwise. Thankfully, when you're looking at the algorithms, you can really just pay attention to the arrows. So as long as you hold your cube in the right orientation, you can just pay attention to the arrows and they'll work great for you.